Okay, let's go. Jeff, will you tell the story? Tell the story of what's going on right now, what happened.
Well, I was supposed to do a show in St. Pete, and nobody showed up. And
that's not.
And so I was able to race back to fill in for Lance, who didn't show up. No, this is a no-show Shaw show.
No-show redemption.
Yeah.
The Shaw Shaw. The Shaw Show redemption.
He won't shank you.
And you know what's really great? It's July 2021. Everyone's getting vaccinated. Everything's opening up. People are going out, which means I have zero excuse for having no people at my show tonight.
Yeah, zero excuse.
Well, except that it's Sarasota, so everybody's already in bed.
It's St. Pete. It's St. Pete. So
St. Pete Beach.
Take it back.
Yeah, St. Pete Beach, which is Spanish for St. Pete bitch.
Oh.
Or so I've been told. I can't really believe everything I hear from someone wearing a MAGA hat. So am I ready to do my little thing?
Do your thing.
All right. First, I want to say that I've been watching the shows on YouTube, and everybody's been doing great. And I'm glad that my career's falling apart so I can join the show again.
Yes. Join the losers. Join the losers.
It's great to be here. I'm staying in an Airbnb, and the owner said, "Well, you're a comedian, huh? I haven't seen you on TV. Are you any good?" I said, "Good enough that I don't have to rent my house out to pay the bills."
No.
Let me rephrase that. Good enough that I don't have to rent my parents' house out to pay the bills. And I'm so glad to see you guys again. Hope everybody had a nice 4th of July. I love 4th of July, a holiday we Americans celebrate with alcohol and fireworks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because what better way to celebrate the separation of the colonies from England than with the separation of your fingers from your hand?
Oh, wowee.
Yeah.
I'm having a good time in St. Pete. Yesterday, I did a daytime corporate show for a senior community in Cocoa Beach, a very big senior community. The name of the community was Cocoa Beach.
Which is Spanish for
Cocoa Beach. Which was my male stripper name in the 90s. Turns out you don't need two coconuts to carry the nickname. So anyway, I did this show, and it wasn't an assisted living facility. It was an independent senior community. The activities director wanted me to understand that everyone there, aged 75 to 91 was the age of the residents, that everyone there was independent and most of them still drive, which made me even more excited about the show, because not only did I get to bring smiles to the faces of some seniors, but I got to keep the streets of Cocoa Beach safe for 1 hour. Comedian Jeff Shaw turning off left-hand turn signals one joke at a time. And for those of you who are seeing me for the first time, my name is Jeff, and my pronoun is they, because I'm tired of using he and having people go, huh? That's actually a thing these days, pronouns. Today I ordered a skinny decaf latte with cinnamon, and the barista asked me for my pronoun. I said he, but seeing how I just ordered a skinny decaf latte with cinnamon, I'm pretty sure she is still on the table. He said, sir, pronouns are no laughing matter. I said, in that case, my pronoun is yours and my preposition is up. Unfortunately, he got that joke more quickly than you did, and I didn't get my cinnamon.
Saliva.
Yeah. And I am excited about going on the ships again. Mm. And that means Brad and I and our other ship comics, we're going to be flying again. Air travel is back, but so is air rage. Whoop, whoop. Which is great for frequent travelers, frequent flyers such as Brad and myself, because chances are we've already seen the in-flight movie, but entitled Karen versus Bitter Flight Attendant never gets old. I hate wearing a face mask. Yeah, well, I hate my job. Let's overreact and try to go viral. Ladies and gentlemen, the captain has put on the get your phones ready to record sign. I am gold status with American Airlines, and some gold members think that some people think being gold status makes them better than everyone else on the plane. And by some people, I mean me. Whenever our plane hits really bad turbulence and everyone's like, oh no, we're all gonna die, I'm like, yeah, well, the line into heaven starts behind me, because I am gold, bitches. For those of you who speak Spanish, beaches.
Coco beaches.
That's Copac, baby. Copac City. And I'll wrap it up here. And I love being gold status because American pampers me. The last time I flew, I asked my flight attendant for a Diet Coke. And she said, would you like the whole can? I said, the whole can? Do you think I deserve the whole can? 12 ounces of soda on a four-hour flight that cost me $400? Maybe you should just pour some Diet Coke into a Dixie cup until I can claw myself up to platinum. An airline pilot is a very important job, but nobody respects airplane pilots, and nobody can pronounce them correctly either. I tell jokes for an hour. Everybody lines up to shake my hand and tell me how funny I am in theory. But a pilot flies 300 souls safely when one goes to the other and everyone's like, out of my way, Sully, you just made me 10 minutes late for my Cinnabon. Ever see an airline pilot accidentally cut the line at the airport Starbucks because he doesn't know where it forms? Everyone's like, who the hell does that guy think he is? And I'm like, he's the guy who needs caffeine so he doesn't fly us into a mountain. In fact, everybody open your wallets. We're going to fill him so full of espresso he can fly us to Honolulu just by flapping his arms. Hey, you guys been great. Thank you so much.
Jeff Shaw, come on. Yeah. Jeff, I'm going to say this, that was one of the greatest sets in history. Come on, everybody, let's see it.